Hello students, today I am going to take up poem 1, The Road Not Taken by Robert Frost from the textbook Beehive. Robert Frost is an American poet whose work was first published in England because his work was rejected by American publishers. He is known for his laconic language. Laconic means with the use of very less words one is able to express his idea. So he is known for his laconic writing style. And his poetry always reflect individualism and rural England. He chose old-fashioned way to be new. And his famous poem, this poem which you are going to study, The Road Not Taken, belonged to his collection of poems called Mountain Interval. Robert Frost also received Pulitzer Award 4 times in his life. Pulitzer Award is given for poetry. And he is also known as Poet Laureate of Vermont. Vermont is the place. Let's move on to the poem now. This poem is about making choices in our life and the choices or the opportunities that shape our future. Many a times in our life, we come across such opportunities or alternatives or choices. But we have to select only one. And it is only the future that will reveal whether the decision taken by us is wrong or not. Being a student, you can easily relate to this poem because in a student's life also, the students come across many such options or opportunities in their lives. For example, after passing class 12, the students have so many opportunities, choices and options and they have to select one. In terms of their career, in terms of their studies, in terms of their job, whatever. So, everyone has to decide at certain point of time which way to go or which path they should choose. So, this poem talks about such opportunities, choices and complexities. Let's begin the first stanza. Two roads diverged in a yellow wood, and sorry, I could not travel both. And be one traveller long I stood, and looked down one as far as I could, to where it bent in the undergrowth. This is a narrative poem because the poet is talking about his personal experience, what he experienced when one morning he was passing by a yellow wood. Here yellow wood is referred to a part of the forest where yellow leaves are found. And why there are yellow leaves? Because it is autumn season. You must have noticed in autumn season, you will find yellow leaves because the trees shed their yellow leaves. And then after that, green leaves appear on the branches of the trees. So it appears yellow because of the yellow leaves which are fallen from the trees, which are fallen on the road. Two roads diverged in a yellow wood. He is saying that while passing by a forest area while passing by a yellow wood, he observes that two roads are diverged, means there is a junction, there is a point where the two roads are diverged in two different directions. And he says, and sorry I could not travel both. He is feeling sorry because he wanted to take both the roads, but it was not possible for him because he had to choose one. So he says that, and sorry I could not travel both, because it was not possible for him to travel on both the roads. He had to take one path. He had to take one road out of two. Here the road is referred to the path, but it has a deep meaning. It is also a symbol of the choices. So he says, further he says, and be one traveler long I stood and looked down one as far as I could. So he says that I was a traveler. I was the only traveler who was passing by that forest area, that wood. And I stood at that point and looking down on one road till the point to where it bent in the undergrowth. Here undergrowth means dense growth of plants and bushes. Right? So in this stanza, basically the poet wants to tell that one morning when he was standing in a wood while passing by the forest area or yellow wood. It was autumn season and he reached a junction point where the road was split into two directions. Now he had to make a choice between the two. Though he wanted to travel both the roads, but it was not possible for him. So he stood there in dilemma for a long time and he was not able to decide which path he should go on. Here the road represents choice and the undergrowth represents that unknown world in which we live, or a state of confusion or dilemma when we are not able to decide, when we have to decide or when we have to choose one way out of two or out of many, then we are confused. That state is referred here as unknown world. Let's move on to stanza 2. Then took the other just as fair and having perhaps the better claim, because it was grassy and wanted wear. Though as for that the passing there had warned them really about the same. So in this stanza, the poet says that he selects the road that appears at first glance to be less travelled. This stanza suggests that he has an independent spirit and does not wish to follow the crowd. And after a moment, he changes his mind, concluding that both the roads are equally worn out. After standing for a long time at the diversion of roads at that point, he decided to choose one road. Now, he realized the road which was looking less traveled by the other people, he decided to take that road, because he did not want to go in the direction in which many other people had traveled. So, he made his independent decision of taking the road which was less traveled by. As soon as he started moving on that road, very soon he realized that it was also equally worn out or equally traveled by the other people like the first road. But now he could not change his decision. He could not change his path. Let's begin stanza 3. And both that morning equally lay in leaves, no step had trodden black. Oh, I kept the first for another day. Yet knowing how way leads on to way, I doubted if I should ever come back. In these lines, the poet wants to tell the readers that when a person takes a decision, it is not possible to reverse it. He says that leaves that morning, both the roads were equally covered. Equally lay means were equally covered with yellow leaves. That shows that no one had taken that path. This symbolizes that the choices in life open to the poet are both unknown to him. He is not aware of the result or the consequences of the decision made by him. In leaves, no step had trodden black. Here, trodden black is referred to the path which turns black by crushing the leaves. Means the color was still yellow. That shows or that symbolizes that it was not used by the other people. So the poet remains committed to his decision to take the road he had previously selected, saying that he will save the other road for another day. This symbolizes that he will make the other choice in life later in his life only if he is not satisfied with the results of the first choice. But at the same time, he observes that he will probably never pass this way again, as one path leads to another and thus will never have an opportunity to take the road again. This symbolizes that he will not be able to take the second choice in life at all. By these lines, we can interpret that we always face such situations in our life, and only after weighing everything we decide to choose our path. We are not aware of the decisions we are taking or choices we are making are correct or wrong. But later in our life, we realize that the decision we took in the past was not wise or was a good or wise decision. We face consequences later in our life. So we can say the irony of life is it is unpredictable. There is no certainty. We are not sure of anything. Life is actually what happens between the choices, and making the right choice makes all the difference. Now the last stanza. I shall be telling this with a sigh, somewhere ages and ages hence. Two roads diverged in a wood, and I took the one less travelled by, and that has made all the difference. In these lines, the poet takes the readers into the future. The poet would be telling the generations to come that he took the less travelled road. That means, in the years to come, the poet will be telling others about his choice, the choice he made in the past. Means that he will talk about what decision in life he took. And while doing so, he will sigh. S-I-G-H, sigh means it is a deep breath either of relief or regret. So he will sigh either with relief or regret whether he made the right decision or the wrong one. According to the poet, he knew that he had chosen a more challenging path, different path. And he thinks that if he had taken the other road, his life would have been different. Now the question arises, what was the result of the poet's decision of taking the less traveled road? We can say that the result was his life was changed. That's why he has used the word difference. So choosing the less traveled road instead of the other one has made all the difference in his life. Analysis of the poem. In this poem, the poet has shown that choices have consequences, and in fact consequences are what make choices important. And whenever we are at crossroads, we make choices sometimes without realizing their outcomes. Well-decided and correct choices are often celebrated, while the impulsive and wrong ones are regretted. The poet has expressed life as a combination of what had happened and what did not. He wants us to realize that the choice we make today affects our future, and unless we walk on the path we have chosen, we don't know where would it take us. Message of the poem is, whatever direction our life takes is determined by our choices or decisions. Our future depends on our decisions or choices we make today. So one should always be careful and wise while taking any decision or making any choice in life. Let's look at the construe now. Poet of the poem is Robert Frost. Style is narrative, means the poet himself is narrating his experience. Theme is choices and dilemma in making the right choice. Structure of the poem is quintet or quintain. 5 lines stanza. This poem is composed in 4 stanzas, each stanza consisting of 5 lines. So the structure is quintet. Rhyme scheme is A, B, A, A, B. And form is rhymed verse. Since there are rhyming words throughout the poem, so it is rhymed verse. Now let's discuss the poetic devices. The poetic devices are the tools which are used by the poet to enhance the meaning or to add rhythm in the poem. The poetic devices used in the poem are symbolism, alliteration, metaphor, anaphora, imagery, personification, and simile. Poetic devices or literary devices. Poetic devices are the tools that a poet uses in poetry to create rhythm and enhance the meaning of the poem. Now look at these poetic devices which are used in the poem The Road Not Taken. First poetic device is symbolism. The use of symbols to represent ideas or qualities is called symbolism. In this poem, the road symbolizes choice and yellow wood symbolizes autumn season. So these are the symbols which are used to represent the ideas. This is called symbolism. Second is alliteration. The repetition of the same consonant sound in the beginning of the words, that is called alliteration. Look at the example. First, for. wanted where, though as for that the. In these lines, FF, WW, were sound, the sound. So the consonant sound is repeated in these lines. So this is called alliteration. Next is metaphor. When we compare a quality of two entirely different things, that is called metaphor. Here in this poem, there is an extended metaphor, like two roads are compared to different options in our life, different kinds of choices or options. Next is anaphora. When same words or phrases are repeated in the consecutive lines of the poem, that is called anaphora. For example, in stanza 1, and sorry, and be one traveler, and looked down, and these words are repeated. This is called anaphora. Next comes imagery. Imagery is the poetic device when certain images or pictures are formed in your mind related to the poem. So when we read this poem, images of nature, yellow leaves, trees, roads are formed in our mind while reading the poem. Next comes personification. It is the poetic device or literary device when human qualities are given to any non-living object. For example, in this poem, there is a line, it wanted wear. It is referred to road. Road is non-living, but it is treated as a living being, as if it wanted wear. Next is simile. Simile is the poetic device when two things are compared using as or like. For example, just as fair. Line 1, stanza 2, just as fair.